When we think about understanding how humans can adapt to global warming in the future, we generally don't think about studying the past, but archaeology might actually have some of the most important answers for how humans can adapt to changes in climate. My name's Jade Guedes, and I'm an archaeologist at Scripps Institution of Oceanography and the Department of Anthropology at the University of California, San Diego. I'm one of the few foreign researchers to have an excavation project on the Tibetan Plateau, and I work in a place called the Zhoujiai Go National Park, which is one of the most biodiverse areas in China. I use 3 to 4 main tools in my research. The first one is I do computational modeling of the impacts that ancient climate had on people and their crops. The second one is I carry out archaeological excavations to access data about how people were living and what they were doing. The third one is I extract animal bones, but mostly the ancient seeds that people used to eat from archaeological sites, and then I identify these in the lab. Billions of research dollars have been spent trying to make the crops that we're most familiar with today, like wheat, rice, corn, and soybean, heat and drought tolerant. But these crops in their natural state are not that way. However, what archaeology has demonstrated is that there are other crops that have been grown by humanity successfully in periods of time that may be as warm as the world's will be under global warming. And we should start looking to these crops as examples of what we could possibly grow in our global warming climate scenario today.